Mercy Otis Warren's father allowed her to be educated alongside her brothers and continually pushed her to, quote, venture beyond a woman's place, end quote. Though Mercy relished her father's confidence in and aspirations for her, Mercy also maintained the desire that most colonial women wanted, to become a wife and mother. On November 14, 1754, Mercy married James Warren, and together they had five sons. The family lived in Plymouth, Massachusetts, which allowed a close proximity to the pre-revolutionary events in Boston. Her brother, famous patriot James Otis, encouraged her involvement in rebellious acts following the passing of the Stamp Act. Mercy saw a role for women in the cause of liberty, and she gladly stepped up using her most efficient weapon, her pen. During the events leading to the War for Independence, Mercy befriended John and Abigail Adams, a friendship that would change her life. John was so impressed with her writing skills that he asked her to join the Patriot cause by creating propaganda publications. Using satirical plays and poems, Mercy helped destroy the reputation and credibility of local crown officials. In 1772, through her play, The Adulator, Mercy predicted that the struggle for liberty could end in bloodshed. As she watched the events unfold around her, she wrote to Abigail Adams, quote, "No one has a stake, a larger share of domestic felicity than myself. I see not less than five sons who must buckle on the harness and perhaps fall a sacrifice to the manes of liberty." With the memory of her favorite brother beaten almost to the point of death by British soldiers fresh in her mind, she pledged her support to Samuel Adams to help drum up support for the boycott of 1774. By this point, she fully believed that only bloodshed would restore the colonists' rights. She boldly wrote, quote, "America stands armed with resolution and virtue, but she recoils at the idea of drawing the sword against the nation from whence she derived her origin. Yet Britain, like an unnatural parent, is ready to plunge her dagger into the bosom of her affectionate offspring. The die is cast. The sword is now our only alternative," end quote. As 1775 arrived, she continued to observe the unrest that surrounded her. She once again wrote to Abigail, quote, "We cannot long continue in this state of suspense. It is and ever has been my poor opinion that justice and liberty will finally gain a complex victory over tyranny," end quote. Unbeknownst to Mercy, she would not have to wait long in a state of suspense. 16 days after her anti-loyalist pamphlet, The Group, was published, the shot heard around the world rang out, and the war that Mercy had predicted began. John Adams encouraged her to continue writing during the war. Through her reputation as the conscience of the Revolution, she met and became correspondents with revolutionary leaders such as George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, Alexander Hamilton, and Elbridge Gerry. The enormity and rarity of her position did not escape her attention. She wrote, quote, "Though I feel a painful concern for their safety, I acknowledge I feel some kind of pride in being so closely connected with persons who dare to act so noble a part," end quote. Due to her unique position among the revolutionary leaders, Mercy decided that she would write a history of the American Revolution. With this goal in mind, she vigilantly observed the world around her and asked for updates from the lawmakers in Philadelphia as well as from the battlefield. After learning of the colonial victory at Dorchester Heights, Mercy wrote about the three generals that Britain had sent to subdue the American rebels. Concerning Burgoyne, she wrote, "He merely, quote, wrote a farce and went home again," end quote. As the war lingered on, Mercy published less and less of her writings. However, she did continue to gather information for her book, which she published in 1805 in three volumes, entitled The History of the Rise, Progress, and Termination of the American Revolution. Due to her sex, Mercy often questioned if she was the right person to author such writings, which is what led her to publish the majority of her works anonymously. Thankfully, she did choose to publish, as a large part of our understanding of the American Revolution, especially from a war widow's perspective, comes from Mercy. As biographer Nancy Stewart said, quote, "Mercy realized that her words could also be as explosive as gunpowder. While they might not ignite muskets and cannons, they might stroke smoldering civic resentments into an open flame," end quote. Through her satire, poems, and willingness to share her political opinion, Mercy Otis Warren helped flame the fires of independence and cemented her place as one of the most influential writers of the American Revolution.